So my part of this is just really itty bitty. But also joining us is Amiel Coco, Jorge's son, who will help with translation. And they are coming up on the stage now. I imagine you're all very tired of hearing from me, so I will be brief. I was first introduced to Jorge's work through the 10th International Art Competition with his submission, The Call. And when you looking up these cycle every 10 seconds, so the bluest of paintings with Christ in the distance, that's the painting. The purpose of these triennials is to showcase the breadth and diversity of the Mormon people and to build the collection through targeted acquisitions. One of the specific goals was to expand the collection outside of the Wasatch Front. I also have a mandate from our collection policy, which encourages the acquisition of non-US Mormon artists. It states, the purpose of the Emerging Regions Global Collection is to emphasize the importance of the worldwide church by paying particular attention, particular collecting attention to art objects created outside the US and Canada in areas currently underrepresented in church collections. So this is a mandate not only within the museum, but also the church history department wide. And the theme of the 10th International Art Competition was Tell Me the Stories of Jesus, and the artists were encouraged to focus on the New Testament. Among those submitted, Jorge's work stood out to me. His style, what he calls sacro-cubism, maintains a figurative and thus narrative form, but it was also informed by modernist mythologies, particularly cubism. But his paintings are brighter and more colorful than that of Picasso and Braque. From this single painting came a much larger commission for 16 paintings, as well as 16 preparatory drawings on the subject, which Jorge completed within a year. Jorge Coco San Angelo had already been exploring the idea of doing a major body of work on the subject, and when I spoke to his son, Amiel, about acquiring The Call, he pitched the project to me with excitement and collectively convinced me. It was precisely the type of work I was looking for. Fast forward 1 year. The Sunday School Department approached me this year as they were looking to improve the artwork in curriculum. Particularly, they were working on the New Testament manual and said they were tired of Harry Anderson. So are we. Mark Magleby, Ashley Whitaker, and myself gave presentations on religious art, and from those meetings came smaller, exploratory meetings with Susan Easton Black and Elder Durand. Among their favorites, of course, was Jorge Coco San Angelo. While those manuals are still in the works, the acquisition of his painting was absolutely well-timed and met a long-desired demand for devotional work outside of the de facto Harry Anderson, work that reflected the growing population of the Mormon people. So with that, for Chase and Jorge, I'm so excited to hear your discussion. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Laura and Glenn. I'm behind the monitor, so I don't know how loud I'm being, so tell me if I'm being. Okay, all right. And Glenn's invitation for you to come closer is consistent with the tone that we'd like to strike here at Brother Coco's request. We want to keep it casual and conversational, so forgive us any informalities. And I have a kind of loose structure of questions that we're going to go through, but we will also try to be responsive and kind of follow the lead that he sets in wanting to describe and talk to you about his work. So I'll begin with a fairly broad question. It says, the description on your website says, I quote, I create art that helps you access spiritual feelings, which is a kind of broad mission statement. When and how did you develop that sense of spiritual purpose within your art?
La descripción en tu website dice, creo arte que te ayuda a accesar sentimientos espirituales. ¿Cuándo y cómo desarrolló este sentido de propósito espiritual dentro del arte?
Yo creo que mi devoción a la creación ha sido nata en mí. Aunque no,
I believe my devotion to my devotion to the spiritual was from birth.
Aunque no pinté específicamente temas religiosos,
even when I didn't paint specifically religious paintings,
pintando la naturaleza, pintando el ser humano,
painting nature and the human being,
estaba tratando siempre de hacer un homenaje al creador.
I was always trying to give an homage to the creator.
Al maravillarme ante la belleza y la perfección de las formas que podemos ver.
Marveling, being marveled about the forms and the creations that we can see.
Pero específicamente,
but specifically,
al convertirme en la iglesia,
when I was converted into the church,
comencé a trabajar en dos líneas.
I started working in two different lines.
Una, siguiendo la investigación de mi expresión libre.
One, following my own investigation of free expression.
Y otra, trabajando con temas que ingresaban a mi conocimiento por el conocimiento del Evangelio.
And the other one that was parallel to the knowledge, the new knowledge of the gospel.
Gracias. Another follow-up question. You have referred to your style of abstraction as sacro-cubism, and there's great examples of that being displayed behind us. Where does that term come from? And as a follow-up to that, how does the choice to work in an abstract or reductive visual language complement the subject matter and objectives of your work?
Te has referido a tu estilo de abstracción como sacrocubismo. ¿Dónde y cómo llegó ese término? Y como seguimiento a esa pregunta, ¿cómo es que la decisión de trabajar en abstracto y reducir las imágenes, en simplificar las imágenes, completan esa idea de traer espiritualidad en su trabajo?
Como les comenté hace unas palabras atrás,
as I just stated,
la pintura religiosa que yo hacía,
the religious art that I was creating,
era convencional.
It was conventional.
A raíz de la influencia,
being influenced,
de las publicaciones de la iglesia que eran,
from church publications,
que eran totalmente figurativas,
that were figurative.
Sin embargo, por el otro lado, yo continuaba avanzando en una investigación de la parte artística.
On the other hand, I was exploring other artistic expressions.
Entonces, el año pasado, yo decidí.
Then last year I decided.
Juntar a algunos de los conocimientos.
To put together the two kinds of knowledge.
Del arte moderno.
Of modern art.
Con un tema explícitamente religioso.
With an religious theme.
Y traté de hacer un balance.
So I tried to balance.
Entre los mejores elementos de la arte artística.
Between the best elements of the artistic.
Con los temas religiosos.
The artistic methods and the religious themes.
A fin de que contenga el tema comprensible a la gente que observa.
So the theme will be comprehensible for the people observing the art.
Pero que incluya la.
But that it would include.
La síntesis.
The synthesis.
Y la potencia.
And the the power.
Que tienen las formas geométricas.
That the geometric forms
del cubismo.
The cubism geometric forms can convey.
Hay un axioma que
there is an axiom
que dice a menor información.
When you have less information,
mayor comunicación.
There is more communication.
Entonces la síntesis geométrica,
so synthesizing geometrically,
permanece en la memoria.
It's engraved into the memory.
Acompaña e impacta a la persona que la ha visto.
Accompanies and impacts the person who is seeing it.
Por ejemplo, los símbolos.
For instance, the symbols.
Desde la antigüedad.
From ancient times.
Como el círculo.
Like the circle.
El cuadrado.
The square.
Triángulo.
Triangle.
La cruz.
The cross.
Y otras formas combinadas.
And other combined forms.
Han acompañado la historia de la humanidad.
Have been around throughout history.
Sin ser alterados.
Without being altered.
Y todas estas formas tienen un gran contenido simbólico.
And all these forms have a great symbolic content.
Por eso trato de simplificar.
That is why I try to simplify.
Y componer la pintura.
And create a painting.
En base a estas formas básicas.
Going back to the basics.
Que a veces no son percibidas inmediatamente por el observador.
Which sometimes are not comprehended instantly by the viewer.
Pero que ayudan a tenerlo en su mente y en su retina.
But it helps to be retained in their mind and their eye.
Y a comunicar la parte más profunda del arte visual.
And to communicate the deepest or the deeper meaning of the art.
That's great, thank you, gracias. At the risk of being a little redundant and at the risk of being sort of anti-academic and asking a very like Mormon question.
Pregunta muy mormona.
I'm gonna jump ahead, a question I had planned for a little later. In an essay, By Simple Yet Propitious Means by Herman de Toit, you talk about the use of abstraction in your work, saying the lines, forms, and colors can express the meaning more directly. The idea being that viewers can enjoy an aesthetic experience that leads them into the subject matter. How does this idea that an emotional impression can lead to knowledge relate to Alma's description of faith in Alma 32?
That's a long one. En el ensayo de simple pero métodos propios de Herman de Toit, hablas sobre el uso de la abstracción en tu trabajo, diciendo las líneas, las formas y los colores pueden expresar el significado más directamente. La idea es que el observador pueda disfrutar la experiencia estética que los lleva hacia el tema. ¿Cómo esta idea de que una impresión emocional puede guiar al conocimiento se relaciona con la descripción de Alma sobre la semilla de la fe en Alma 32?
Obviamente esto requiere un ejercicio del observador.
Obviously, this requires an exercise from the observer.
La mayoría del público está acostumbrada.
Most of the viewers are used to
seguir la anécdota del cuadro. Observar qué es lo que pasó en ese momento de la escena.
Okay, so the viewer is used to just understand what they see directly. what is given to them in the painting.
Pero una buena pintura,
but a good painting,
puede relatar el acontecimiento,
can tell a story,
y a la vez,
and at the same time,
utilizar la forma,
utilize form,
luz,
light,
color,
color,
organización,
organization,
que sea coherente con esa historia,
that will be coherent to that story.
Es decir, hay una contenido emocional,
I mean to say that there is an emotional content,
y espiritual,
and spiritual,
en cada forma,
in each form.
A veces, cotidianamente,
sometimes in our everyday life,
podemos sentir ese impacto,
we can feel that impact,
observando la naturaleza,
observing nature.
Pero desconocemos por qué nos impacta.
But we don't understand why it makes an impression on us.
El Señor ha diseñado a la naturaleza.
The Lord designed nature.
Y aparte de la utilidad que tiene el mundo físico que nos rodea,
besides the function of everything that surrounds us,
hay una comunicación espiritual,
there is a spiritual communication,
diferente en cada forma creada,
that is different in every created form.
Y la capacidad de emocionarnos ante lo creado,
and our own ability to be touched by everything created,
nos refina,
refines us
como seres humanos,
as human beings,
y nos eleva espiritualmente,
and it elevates us spiritually.
La creación no solo está hecha para ser utilizada,
the creation is not it hasn't been done only to be utilized,
sino para ser observada,
but also to be observed,
y consumida,
and consumed,
por nuestra mente y
by our minds and our spirits.
Es un objetivo que la mayoría de la gente escapa a sus necesidades.
That is an objective that sometimes we miss.
Lo mismo ocurre con el arte visual.
The same thing happens to visual art.
Lo que el artista hace es aprender.
What the artist does is to learn
de todo lo que ha sido creado,
from everything created,
y recoger los elementos,
and he gathers the elements
que le sirven para dar un mensaje,
that will help him give a message.
Y como decía al principio,
as I said before,
la gente común,
regular people,
necesita ver más arte,
need to see more art,
para refinarse,
to be refined,
y habilitarse,
and make themselves able to,
para recibir el beneficio de oculto que a veces está en esa obra.
So able to be able to receive the benefit that is hidden in that painting.
Es claro, necesitamos.
Was it?
Está bien. So I'm going to switch gears a little bit. Laura talked about the importance of extending the church's collection out beyond the Wasatch Front. I'm not from Utah, is it Wasatch? Anyway, so. As an extension of that, there is also, and I wanted to combine that with this idea from Doctrine and Covenants 90:11. In Doctrine and Covenants section 90, verse 11, it prophesies that through the restoration, every man shall hear the fullness of the gospel in his own tongue and in his own language. As a Latin American artist specifically, How does or can your work contribute to that mission by preaching the gospel through the visual language of art?
¿Tiene sentido? Sí, como siguiendo frases anteriores.
So, continuing with the same idea.
La comunicación que hace Dios con lo creado es universal.
The communication that God has with what is created is universal.
El artista entonces es un medio más.
So the artist is one more medium.
Y el lenguaje artístico,
an artistic language,
cualquiera que sea su manera de expresarse,
anyway that is the artist chosen expression,
tiene un lenguaje que
it is a language
que rompe las fronteras,
that crosses borders,
de idiomas,
of language,
razas,
races,
y culturas,
and cultures.
Y el evangelio puede ayudar,
and the gospel can help,
por medio del arte visual,
through visual art,
a comunicarse con cualquiera,
to communicate with anyone.
Por eso creo que todavía los artistas tenemos que realizar una función más expansiva en el terreno.
I believe artists need to do a more extensive work in that area.
El mormonismo tiene que ser representado.
Mormonism needs to be represented.
No solo por el arte.
Not only by art,
sino por todas las otras actividades humanas,
but also through all other human activities,
de propósitos elevados,
of high
purposes.
High purposes.
That, so speaking, to kind of circle back around from that, and maybe to come back a little bit to my initial question, despite the universality of art, you in your depictions and your paintings of Book of Mormon stories went to great efforts to even including extensive research, to ensure that you are depicting those peoples in an appropriate way, that you are depicting them in pre-Columbian aspect, if that makes sense. Was making sure that they were presented not as basically white people dressed in theatrical depictions of, you know, Latin American styles of dress, but they were depicted as the inhabitants themselves of this place and of those times. And why was it so important to put in that effort to make sure that those Book of Mormon stories were depicted accurately in that cultural sense?
Cuando hacías las otras pinturas más ilustrativas, y te aseguraste de que de estudiar y hacer las representaciones de las caras y las instrumentarias realmente como eran, no blancos y vestidos. ¿Por qué fue eso importante?
Bueno, el arte de la América Antigua ha sido un atractivo de mucho tiempo para mí.
Ancient American art has been very attractive to me from a long time ago.
Y un tema de interés y de estudio.
And I've studied this for a long time.
En los años que vivía en México,
during my time living in Mexico,
Tuve la oportunidad de convivir con
I had the opportunity to be close quarters
con parte de los descendientes de la historia del Libro de Mormón,
with many of the descendants of the stories of the Book of Mormon,
y de estudiar sus su arte, sus construcciones.
And I was able to study their art, their buildings.
Y entonces yo pude captar un poco más la antropología de este pueblo.
I was able to capture the anthropology of these cultures.
Y también de los restos de estas grandes civilizaciones desaparecidas.
And also these great civilizations that are non-existent today.
Entonces mi meta fue pintar con la mayor autenticidad posible.
My goal was to paint with the most authentic as I could.
Los acontecimientos relatados en el Libro de Mormón.
The events told in the Book of Mormon.
Some of your family, including your son Amiel, are here with us today. As an artist and also as a father, what role did art play in the home growing up when you were raising your children? Was art useful to you in communicating spiritual lessons to your children? And then what role do you think art can or should play in family life in making the home a sacred and a spiritual place?
En su hogar, ¿qué tipo de arte tenían y qué papel ha tenido el arte en el criar a una familia?
Sí, ¿qué papel sirvió el de poder educar a sus hijos en las temas y las lecciones?
Mi hogar no era un hogar con un taller de arte, sino un taller de arte con una casa adosada a él.
My home wasn't a home with an art studio. My home was an art studio with a little living quarter.
Así que los cuadros no solo estaban en el caballete o en las paredes, sino hasta debajo de la cama, ¿no?
Paintings were not only at the easel or on the walls, but also even under the bed. ¿Cuál es la influencia que eso ha tenido en la vida de su familia?
Sí, la influencia ha sido muy poderosa, ¿no? Porque
influence is very powerful.
Ellos no solo recibían el evangelio en la capilla los domingos.
My family not only received the gospel at church on Sundays,
sino a través de mi actividad, creo que recibieron muchísimas cosas valiosas.
But also through my activity, they received many valuable things.
This is a somewhat complicated question, and it does touch on themes we've already addressed, but I'd still like to hear your thoughts. In a 2006 Church News article, and Amiel, I'm going to go ahead and read the whole thing and then let you translate, or do you want to do it in spurts? Little pieces to make it. Yeah, that one's on there. It's in the 2006 Church News article, and I'll read it while you look up there. In a 2006 Church News article, you spoke about three important factors in the making of your work. To quote, "My accumulated academic training, the available documentation of ancient American cultures, and finally, inspiration to penetrate time and space to offer the observer images reflecting as close as possible what might have been in that marvelous ebook. Can you talk more about the balance between training, research, and inspiration in your work?"
En el 2006, en un artículo de Church News, hablaste sobre tres importantes factores al hacer tu trabajo. Dice, con citas, mi entrenamiento académico, la documentación disponible de el observador de las culturas de la América Antigua y finalmente la inspiración para penetrar el tiempo y el espacio para ofrecer al observador imágenes que reflejan lo más cercanamente posible lo que pudo haber sido aquella maravillosa época. Cierre de cita. ¿Puede hablar un poco más sobre el balance entre el entrenamiento, la búsqueda y la inspiración en su trabajo?
Sí, yo creo que cada ser humano está preparado para algo.
I believe every human being has been prepared for something.
Algunos descubrimos afortunadamente muy temprano esa finalidad que tiene en la vida.
Fortunately, some of us discovered this purpose in life early in life.
Siempre supe lo que yo tenía que hacer.
I always knew what I needed to be, to become.
Sí, y la inspiración para mí es el punto de partida.
Inspiration to me is the starting point.
Cuando tengo necesidad de trabajar sobre un tema,
when I have the need to work on a given theme,
la lectura de las escrituras,
reading the scriptures,
produce inmediatamente imágenes en mi mente.
Immediately produce images in my mind.
Son muy sutiles.
They are subtle.
Difíciles de agarrar.
Sometimes hard to grasp.
Pero a veces estoy viendo como una película que da vueltas alrededor de esta escena.
But sometimes I see like a movie around the scene.
Entonces yo hago un sketch rápido tratando de copiar aquello que vi en mi mente.
So quickly I draw a sketch trying to copy what I saw in my mind.
Bueno, hasta ahí es la parte inspirativa.
Up to that point is the inspirational part.
Y luego viene un trabajo riguroso.
Then it comes a rigorous work.
Intelectual.
That is intellectual.
De acomodar.
To put together.
Toda esta idea difusa.
All this vague idea.
En un espacio.
Into space.
Coherente.
A coherent space.
Sí. Organizado.
Organized.
Y que exprese aquella escena.
And I will express that scene
lo mejor posible.
In the best possible way.
Y esto es parte del desarrollo.
This is part of the development
de una destreza
of an ability
con la que tiene que enfrentarse cualquier persona.
That any person needs to be confronted with
dentro de su propio oficio
in their own area of expertise.
Este trabajo para mí, esta lucha no ha terminado.
This struggle is not finished in my life.
Sí, siempre estoy tratando de conseguir.
I'm always trying to
mejores maneras,
to achieve better ways,
más bellas,
more beautiful,
y más fuertes,
and more potent,
y más ligadas
and
a la verdad,
closer to the truth.
As a kind of follow-up to that, people have commented on the unique selections that you made among the scenes that you depicted of Christ's life for the series that you produced for the church. Was the selection of those scenes, were those a result of that inspirational process that you described, or were there often or also conscious decisions to choose scenes that are less frequently depicted?
Algunas personas han comentado sobre la selección de esta serie de trabajos. ¿Fue algo inspirado o algo más intelectualmente, una decisión más intelectual de haber escogido cada una de las escenas?
Porque algunas de las escenas son las típicas, pero son las que no se trata mucho en el arte.
Sí, es verdad. Algunos de los temas no se habían pintado anteriormente.
It is true. Some of the themes I depicted for the church hadn't been painted before.
Y de los que se habían pintado,
and of the ones that had been painted,
había enfoques,
the point of view,
nuevos para mí.
Were new to me.
No sé de dónde viene, pero sé que tengo que hacerlo, así que creo que es casi como un mandato.
I don't know where it comes from, but I know I need to do it, almost like a mandate.
Como dije hoy, este es el primer empuje que siento.
So this is the first impulse I receive.
Y después hago la especulación intelectual.
Then I intellectually speculate.
Y pienso, qué bueno poder hacer tal tema o hacerlo de esta manera.
And I think it would be nice if I could do this theme in this way or the other.
También quisiera decirles,
I would also like to tell you,
que la catarata de ideas,
that the flow of ideas,
superan mi tiempo físico real,
is beyond my possibilities. My
there are more ideas than time to paint.
Yes. Yeah. So more ideas than what he can actually.
Yo he tenido que sacrificar mucho tiempo creativo.
And I had to sacrifice a lot of my creative time.
Para hacer un trabajo paralelo al arte.
To do parallel work.
Para la subsistencia.
To make ends meet.
Y es una lástima.
And it's a shame.
Por eso pienso que los artistas deben recibir mayor apoyo.
And I think artists should receive more support.
Y dejarlos hacer lo que ellos mejor pueden hacer.
And let them do what they can do the best.
Así que.
So he says,
siga, hermano.
He says, no. We need sponsors.
Yo estoy muy agradecido por.
I am very thankful
por los coleccionistas.
For collectors.
Muy agradecido a Laura.
Very grateful to Laura.
Que abrió una puerta muy grande para mí.
That opened a beautiful door to me.
Y a todos los que contribuyen.
And to everyone who contributes,
a que estas ideas se debatan,
that these ideas may be talked about,
se conozcan, se compartan,
be known and shared,
y que el mormonismo pueda ingresar,
and that Mormonism can
al mundo
be introduced to the world.
con lo mejor que puede producir sus miembros.
With the best that their members can produce.
Muchas gracias. I think that probably is a good stopping place in terms of turning it over to a general discussion. If there's interest, questions, or comments that would like to be presented to Brother Coco, please, in Spanish.
A pesar de los mejores esfuerzos de nuestros misioneros a través de los años, Argentina sigue siendo un país católico.
Pero,
¿qué recepción ha tenido su arte religiosa entre la población argentina?
To translate, so he's saying, despite the best efforts of our missionaries, Argentina has remained a strongly Catholic country, unlike Chile, for example. I'm interjecting that comment. But how has your, in light of that, how has your art, which is so strongly Mormon in some cases, how has your art been received by the Argentinian public? Yeah, and the religious art in by an Argentinian public.
Es verdad, el catolicismo tiene una presión muy cultural muy fuerte en la población.
So it's true, Catholicism has a very strong cultural influence in the population.
Y por mi parte, yo he tratado de mostrar algunas escenas a público no miembro.
I have tried to show some of these paintings to the non-members.
De lo que pasó con nuestras culturas antiguas.
Of what happened to our ancient.
Y pienso que
people.
Es un camino para romper esa.
And it might be a way to break into that state of mind.
Obviamente, yo he hecho muchas exposiciones de arte secular.
Obviously, I have had many exhibits with other types of art.
Sin incluir pintura religiosa.
Which does not include religious paintings.
Pero pienso que a través de ello, a través de este trabajo, gente que no conoce el Evangelio,
but through this other art that people that don't know the gospel,
puede estar mejor preparada,
might be better prepared,
espiritualmente,
spiritually,
para recibir el mensaje,
to accept the gospel.
Puesto que casi toda mi obra no específicamente mormona,
because all of my work, even when it's not specifically LDS,
tiene un carácter místico,
has a mystic side of it.
Entonces la gente empieza a ver que hay otro lado de las cosas que existen y que no se ven.
So people are starting to realize that there is another side beyond what the eye can see the first sight.
Sí, es un trabajo de hormiga, pero algo hay que hacer.
it's an ant's work.
It's a small work, but yes. I love that idea that the even when it isn't explicitly religious, obviously, that the refining influence of art can prepare people to be opened up to the possibilities of realities beyond the visible. That's a beautiful idea.
Sí, le gusta mucho la idea de que el arte que no es religioso de todas maneras los prepara para recibir algo espiritual.
Sí, yes, thank you. Additional questions or comments, please.
A mí me interesaría saber, I would like to know, su reacción a este comentario de esta idea de que el estilo de sacro cubanismo se crea sacro cubanismo.
Sacro cubismo.
La manera en la cual se recibe la inspiración de la cantidad simbólica y de los colores que son diversas y difusas, etc. Is Syncretism a mirror of the manner in which we receive revelation with its emphasis on form, symbol, and its use to God? Otra vez, un espejo de la manera en la cual el ser humano puede percibir lo divino.
Thank you, gracias. Esa palabra no está todavía incluida en la historia del arte, sacro cubismo.
Sacro cubism is not yet in the dictionary of art.
Pero fue creada un poco casual en un intercambio de diálogo.
But it was created casually in a conversation.
No gustó para identificar esta línea de trabajo.
We thought it was catchy and we like to identify my work with this.
Hay también, como seguir la pregunta que nos hizo el hermano, una relación entre el simbolismo que lleva el sacro cubismo y la manera en que también el simbolismo es parte de la manera en la que recibimos revelación. Si hay una paralela, se puede decir, entre las dos estructuras, se puede decir, ¿no?
Sí, tiene un, este estilo tiene una relación importante.
This style has a very important relation.
En la comunicación espiritual.
In spiritual communication.
Yo mencioné algo sobre la forma geométricas.
I spoke a little bit about the geometric forms.
La síntesis.
The synthesis.
Y la libertad de poner colores.
And the freedom to include colors.
Que capten la atención.
That would capture the attention.
Que sean agradables como color.
That would be pleasing as colors.
Pero que a la vez inspiren al tema.
But that also.
Pero que a la vez, sí, que sean bonitas en sí mismo, pero que a la vez sean coherentes con el tema.
So that will be appealing by themselves, the colors, but also that will be coherent with the work.
¿Qué más?
The role of symbolism in the work, and how does that relate to the role of symbolism in scriptures and in revelation?
En las escrituras y la revelación.
Uno puede leer y releer el libro de Mormón y seguir encontrando cosas nuevas.
So you can read and read again the Book of Mormon and continue finding new truths.
Una pintura puede tener muchas cosas escondidas.
A painting will have many hidden things.
Por eso la frecuencia del observador.
That is why the observers.
En ver la misma pintura o en seguir viendo arte.
When the observer continues looking at the same.
Empieza a encontrar cosas.
Painting over and over. The person starts finding new things.
Hay ocasiones donde la persona que ha mirado un cuadro mío me comenta cosas que yo no las había visto tan claramente.
And I have had some people telling me that they've seen things in my paintings that I haven't even noticed myself.
Y que le ha despertado sensaciones que a mí me sorprenden.
And that they have been touched in certain way that surprises me.
Sí, el símbolo es una forma mínima, pero de un contenido muy poderoso.
So the symbol is a a minimal form, but with a very powerful message.
Well, that will conclude our session. Thank you so much, Brother Coco, for the